Welcome back to Shadowgate. We're uncovering the secrets of the catacombs, and we found an ancient well and a door. So before we go poking around further, I want to quickly establish some context so we experience this together. On my first playthrough on Journeyman, alarm bells were going off in this room because I could not accomplish anything. This happened in other places as well, but here specifically, it occurred to me that this is something that's locked off because I'm not playing on Master. There's going to be cool stuff in this game, not just minor changes I can only do on Master. And this place, this ancient well, and this door, old rotting door. So, remember, these catacombs were dug, like, by Telemar using the door. That was about 40 years ago. But this is a ruin, right? There's something very interesting here, I bet. I'm not sure if we can do anything here now, though. Let's see. Because we only have one. Remember, this is locked. I only have one unused key at the moment. Wrought iron key. This is from the ice chamber. Yes, so I imagine the key wouldn't suddenly work on Master. Okay. So if we come back here. What is this thing? Circular stones. Wait, what is it? Set in mortar. Okay. Now I don't think we can climb down there, can we? Crumbling mortar and stone offer no firm foundation. Yes, this is what stumped me. I'm not sure if this is a puzzle I could solve. So what happens when we just jump down? Okay. You stumble to the side of the well and trip head over heels. Your body careens off the rock walls. Ow, 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 before you're rendered unconscious. Okay. Can we, like, find a crossbar, maybe? I don't think using the rope without the hook would work, unless there's something. Can we attach it to the door handle? No. Yes! I know, isn't it? It's killing me! Okay, so do we. Where's the. There's a hotkey. Can we attach this to anything? The pillar! Really? Oh, like the base. Okay, what about. We've got some bars from the iron. We also have a sewer. Can we make a crossbar? No, the sewer crossbar. I mentioned the poker's not going to do anything. Huh. What about the bucket? Magic bucket! One more thing to try. Let's try removing the hook. Alright, so what about this? Can we just tie it? Oh, come on! You can too tie a. Fine. Okay. Gotta come back here. Tunnels. So this was. Whispers and screams. Claustrophobic. Kind of getting dark here. Let's. Yeah, okay. Which I run, this is exciting! Torchlight refracts off the hard geometric edges of the blue mineral. Okay, let's use our. Where's our. Or a lever. Okay, more crystals. I remember this puzzle for the crystals. We do need a number of them, of each color. Okay. There isn't anything like special here, like. It said whispers and screams. There's not like a banshee? Or a ghost? No? Yeah, I think there's just some dead ends in this catacombs. Okay, what about here? This was the foul smell. Otherworldly blue glow. So maybe we're just here for the crystals then. Imagine I don't need more than like 5 or 6. Okay. So it's just a self-contained area. I remember this not being that mazy. I mean, it's probably gonna seem mazy for a little bit, but I think because like the way this game is built, when you go backwards, you only have like one direction you can go backwards, but when you go forward you can like fan out, right? So the catacombs are just like a tree that, again, fans out. Doesn't loop around. Pretty easy to keep track. Okay. Kind of nervous about dying. He's gonna leap out and kill me. Okay. A lot of nothing so far. Let's get some crystals. I'm gonna not pick up every stupid skull. I think at one point I was stuck in my first playthrough, and I'm like, okay, I have to pick up all the skulls for clues. And I want to say that didn't accomplish anything. There's no crystals here. Two small tunnels. Strange breathing sound. Scramping and skittering. What about our... toss a rock in there? No. We need to, like, level up our rock. Can we put a torch in there? Alright, let's just go. Ah. Gremlins? Gargoyles? Yeah, two gargoyles. Slither. Whoa! They're advancing on me. No. He's not really sitting. Wait, whatever. Sniff the air in anticipation of fresh morsel. You. Whoa! I hope that's scripted. Stone-like creature. Bear, mole, and gargoyle. It's a quaved only creature. One we've never seen light of day. Bear, mole, hybrid. So I don't know what to do here. They do give you pretty good clues, I guess. It's the same puzzle as the NES version, so this was another of my carryover hints on my first time. What about a flashbang? You're a mole, you've never seen the light of day? Boom! Flumoris! Momentarily stunning them. Uh-oh. Fight or flash? Is that the solution? Lightning? Remember we looked at a lightning elemental and it said we couldn't, you know, we had to avert our eyes. Well then why doesn't the fire elemental also work? Huh. I don't think we have any other light source, right? We have a torch, but it's obviously like our weakest light source. Some of these do have flashy spells. Okay, because we never used the lightning elemental on Journeyman, let's try this. Aha! Did it kill them? Oh, they catch full runs. Haste retreat, okay. Oh! If they recover and come back, I don't have another lightning elemental. Okay. Strangely silent. Threadbare sack. Even though they all look the same, it's... okay. Scroll. Something. Crystal. I imagine the crystal is just a clue that you can pick up. Crystals, maybe? What is this? Hand followed by pointed star, four vertical lines. Okay, it's a puzzle clue. Get a scroll. Brittle. Careful not to damage. Brother Adnan. Forgive us. We know not the location of the place of power that you spoke of. Continue to search the caverns and ancient chambers below. So are these, like, members of Talamar's forces? If they cover several arrows containing artifacts from a time long past. What these places mean, we cannot tell. Alright, so another possibility is that the Circle of 12, before Talamar rebelled, that the Circle started investigating these caverns, and then Talamar's like, oh, this is my chance. Curse of tea. Oh, so Talamar. Brother Adon. Yeah, so this is before he was still a member of the Circle at this point. Okay. Let us go left first. Okay. Seem quieter, disoriented. You look about, wondering if you've been in this cave before. Perhaps you're going around circles. No, we're not. We have a map. Okay. Let's go up. Rough-hewn timbers. Can you look at the timbers? No. Huh. Skewer steaks. Again, it's mostly flavor, I guess. More caverns. Huh. Oh, now we have crystals. The blackest crystal juts. Okay, let's get those. So apparently the dwarves were getting these, maybe? Okay. Uh-oh. Some power is picking at your mind. Talamar trying to bore into our skull. Hi-ho. Hi-ho. This thing is done. No? Okay. How many of these do I have? Four. Okay. Musty smell. Ooh. Huge mound of bones, like forgotten. Turn away. The enormous significance of it is almost too much to contemplate. The dwarves. Taken from freedom, delivered to slavery, finally death. As you are now, so once was I. Huh. So is this just for lore? Boneyard. I'm gonna take a second and fill out my map. Yeah, okay. Let's move on. So if you watched my previous LP, Legend of the Mystical Ninja on the SNES. What was that? None? Then at the end, I talked a bit about what my next LP was going to be. Wait, I'll go back there. I think I said that I was dying to play the next game I was about to LP. I was a bit, so that was turned out to be this game, although I didn't mention it by name at the time. And the changes to small chamber appears an ancient hideaway. So look at this mirror. Contains various items of scholarly interest. I like to think of myself as a scholar. What's this? It's a pretty big crystal. Huh. The white crystal? A key! Ha ha ha! So remember, there was a key down here somewhere. It hums. Okay, gotta write down all the keys. We haven't found a new key since, I think, so the lion breathing key I think we found with Lackmere's tower. We used to be strutting around like a keymaster. What happened? Okay, so this is a strange glyphs. Well, it hums. So strange and humming. Strange. Humming. Now. The locked door in the top of the evil tower. That was not a humming door, so I'm guessing this is not that key. This could be the key to the ruin, the ancient well area. Although, if this is not a master exclusive key, then that seems doubtful. Thin material, extremely dry and brittle. Wait, I want to save before I do this. I think I remember with this scroll. Pieces of the ancient parchment break off and crumble to dust. It's gone. Yeah. Alright, can we take it with us, though, without ripping it to shreds here, Jair? Careful now. Okay. Better not open this one by mistake. I don't know what to make of this. One theory I had in my previous playthrough is that this is like a time-limited item. You know, like in Doom, some levels have secrets that you have to dash straight towards and grab them. So I'm wondering if that be the case here. Wait, first of all, this... I do not see any drawers. No. I also don't see any dwarves, but... foreign marks. Eat the book. Wait. Is that usually the command for books? Well, this book has been used, so let's try eating it. Your hunger for knowledge is admirable. Probably a better way to achieve it. Well, the book of nothing. Okay. I thought that might have been like a special strange glyphs. Let's read this one. Unable to decipher the strange writing. Is the language you do not know? Is that going to be for all of them? They mean little to you. Except for Tyrion. Of course, you do not read Tyrion. I wonder if this desk is... Talmar. Tylomir, whatever his name is. Thumb along the page. Struck our bargain. I would conceal the Well of Holding by constructing a huge edifice over it. The ancient well? Imbued with magics and living defenses beyond fathoming. Probably not. Built at the junction of all ley lines, the origin, the place of power beyond measure, so the warder could perform his task. Still not know who did this old being, was nor how it came to its purpose. What entity put it on it, this path, and what purpose do I fulfill in this drama? Who this old being was. Okay, I misread that. So this is, I think, the behemoth. So this is Cuthagor's book, our way, way back ancestor. He would conceal the Well of Holding. So it holds the behemoth, maybe, and he concealed it because he's afraid of the power, doesn't understand. Okay. That's my take on it, at least. Cuthagor II. I don't think we've really heard much about him. Begin reading near the top of the page. There I found the source of the strange and terrible visions. It called itself Behemoth, a being beyond understanding. It described its mission as a warder. Okay, so the behemoth is the warder, whose purpose is to guard. When I queried it, the being opened my mind to the terrors of fear, death, disease, strife, and other beings I could not name. Ooh, that's kind of scary. These entities were real and ancient and desired nothing more than to subjugate races. The races. So the behemoth is the good guy? So Talmor wants to do something. He's interested in these things that he could not be named. Okay, these we could not read. What about our Runs of Truth? This is like a... I'm trying to throw you off the trail here that this is just like a joke item. But no. So, read it, please. Aha! You can read from a highlighted passage. Thus shall death be conquered, not with thine staff nor thine sword, but with an embracing of the cold, pitiless arms that await. For lo, ye shall experience much in this realm, and the next, if ye survive, then shall ye be tested anew. Thoroughly confused, you stop reading. Have we read some lore about arms? I don't know. There's definitely different realms going on here. Sounds like a gameplay, like, beat this mode, you got new game plus. Okay, what about the Tyrion? No, okay. Take the books. Looks like someone took a hammer here. Maybe Jair in another life came down this way. Can we go through it? Can we punch it? Can we take our magic hammer? No. That was everything, right? So this is like one big dead end, it looks like. We got the key. Okay, so try the key. The genie is also looking for a key, or the djinn. Yeah, so I was saying that... at the end of my previous LP, I mentioned I was dying to play my next game, this game. Because I knew, or like I strongly believed, that Master would have like lots of changes, lots of new things. So let's take stock. What has been different so far from Journeyman? So the only thing that I know for sure would be, number one, the caves. The early part of the game, the sewer hatch was locked off. That meant you had to like shuffle the skulls in order to get past the force field. So that's one. The other thing is the djinn room, obviously. You couldn't access that in... which tunnel am I at? So I'm going to go up. Came in from the left. The djinn room was not accessible before. And the banshee curse solution did not involve the djinn, it involved the recipes. Difficult to draw a breath. Do we need our cloak? It wouldn't make it this far, though. I wonder... I just had an idea. Does this... can you carry water with you and then put it on your cloak? Try that sometime. Huh. Broken and cracked, the stone statue portrays a large dragon-like creature. Its wings spread, strange words which read... Mortari riseth. I don't remember seeing this. Riseth, rise. Motari, what's that? Is it anything backwards? I... Ratum? No. Okay. Can we smash it to pieces with our hammer? Whoa. Oh, okay. Does he... is this like an idol that we can slot something into? Does he want the bucket? No. Seems like a relic from the past. We speak to it? This thing, this does react to heat. No, it's not his eyeball. Oh, maybe it's a find. Gems? Gem sockets? What is the secret of Evermore? Okay. I don't remember solving this puzzle either. Yeah, so the sewer hatch was closed on Journeyman. The djinn room didn't wasn't accessible. Which is not quite a lot, right? So I'm hoping this Catacombs will have lots more Master exclusive stuff. We say it right. Let's see what happens. My friend, you cannonball into the lava. The molten rock immediately liquefies both you and everything you are wearing. Not even a remnant, nor your failed quest is left. That's exactly what I wanted to do. Good. Yeah. Okay, so even though not a lot of stuff has been different so far, I think I'm still having a blast, if you can't tell. Although, the catacombs, I am going to be slightly disappointed with this part of the game if there isn't new stuff. Can't think of what to do here. I remember trying to bring the ice elemental. That didn't seem to do anything. Is this lava flow different than the... maybe it's just a clue that the dragon is fire related. Huh. Okay, so that was this tunnel. This led to the dwarves and the desk. This was just nothing back there. Or like the lower catacombs, so. So as you see, like these things are very self-contained. Not very maze-like at all. We have plenty of red crystals. Musky animal. Sure it's not just us. It's swimming in sewer water. Hastily constructed beams. We need those beams! Surely cut from the woods within Gatekeeper. Oh, the Gatekeeper. Oh, that's the name of the mountain that we started out on. Okay. Don't need more red crystals. Craft a lone faraway animal. Oh, it's not. It's what's answering the calls that turn your blood cold. Huh. Is the animal under attack? Is this the gong show? I did bring... I said I wasn't going to bring the instruments because I think they're useless. Although the flute turned out to be useful. I did bring the mallet with me, though. This is where the drum in the music room. Bam! Hope that was... didn't mess anything up. Oh, what? Squeals and cries from every opening. Uh-oh. What?
Smelling blood, the horde of goblins pull themselves from the dark crevices around you. Your screams of defiance are for naught as sharp claws and teeth rend you limb from limb.
Punch him!
You have found a hidden death. Tis a sad thing that your adventures have ended here.
Well, I hope we killed a lot of them with our flashbang and our gauntlet. I don't remember that trap being there on Journeyman. I was hoping this would be just like a nice puzzle to end with. Okay. That'll be it for this episode. Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll talk to you next time. Take care, stay safe, and bye for now.